Hello everyone, and welcome to another premier draft of Crimson WoW. The rare is pretty interesting. 2-mana 2-1 flyer, which has a bunch of abilities, well, 2 in addition to the flying ability, of course. So it creates a blood token and then at 5 blood tokens, it will transform into something quite impressive, but it is a fine card to pick here. I mean, the commons aren't really that good here. I mean, they are good commons, but they are not as good as the rare or the uncommon. So the decision, I think, is between the Circle of Confinement and the rare creature. I think the rare creature is a bit better, so I'll take that. Okay, so someone did not want to take a Jacob Hogan. Why? So they took an uncommon because there's only 2 uncommons in this this pack. I will take the Jacob because it's really good, and it's also a mythic rare. I don't have a 4 copies of this thing, but I think even though I wouldn't care about the fact that this thing is a mythic rare and I wanna pick it for my collection is. Even if that didn't matter at all, it's the pick to make here. I mean, what else card would be as good? There's no reason to pick anything else. Let's take the Jacob Hogan. It's really good. And okay, problem with this pack is that the blue and black cards here are not that good. So Unhallowed Phalanx and Wonderlight. Wanderlight, not Wonder, Wanderlight Spirit. They are the only cards for these colors, so I should maybe take the Evolving Wilds or the Ceremonial Knife. And I like the land better here. Hers is useful only in decks that have a lot of easy ways to make this a creature, and of course, I'm not there. I'll take the Evolving Wilds and see what's going on. Another hearse, alright, and there's a. Okay, so there's a hearse, but there's also Wandering Mind and Traveling Minister. They are. Both of these do care about colors. I'm not drafting myself. I might be drafting these colors, but currently I have only blue and black. But. Is this a signal? I mean, I could take the Wandering Mind here, but it's just a 3-mana 2-1. It does draw a card most of the time if you draft around it, but I don't know, maybe the scavenger is just good enough. I'll take the scavenger. I could be blue black steel, but it seems like my colors aren't that open, but then I get this pack. What the heck? So this has only blue and red cards, and well, it has a green card and a black card, but they are not that great. Should I take the exploit card or the scarab? Because I think it's gonna be one of the 5 drops here. Oh man, that's hard. I don't have any food for exploit yet, but I think I might like this slightly better. It's tough. It's tough to decide. Okay, now there's a Doom Descender. I will take that because if I will end up actually getting the blue black deck, I will have some exploit stuff, and I already have now with the Diver's Cup. So the Doomed Dissenter is one of the key cards in the archetype. I think it's pretty easy there, although it had some other blue and black cards as well. Now, Blood Fountain is kind of okay with exploit, but maybe I should take the interaction spell now. I like it slightly more. I don't like the 6-mana thing at all. Here there's Syncopate, Pointed Discussion, and the Undying Malice. The Undying Malice isn't maybe that bad, but Pointed Discussion, yeah, I don't think I care about blood tokens that much. I'll take the cheapest card here. It's playable. I might also it's all perfectly cuttable as well. Here it's the 6 drop. Again, I don't like it too much, but I can take the 4-mana draw spell. The Siphon Essence isn't that interesting. And now, okay, what is the. There are two quite reasonable red cards. Still in the pack. I suppose I still take the six drop here, but man, I don't like the fact that I mean, maybe my colors were wrong, I don't know. But anyway, here it's between Ceremonial Knife and the Vandalite Spirit. I think I now just like the deck in every deck I have, and I don't like the thing that can't block ground creature, so I'll take the knife here. And here it's the Servitor or the Entomber. I have no three drops, but I think I will be getting them. I don't think I wanna. Yeah, I'll take the Servitor. I don't think I'm gonna. Okay, this is fine too now, this late. But I don't think I care about the one, 2 mana 1/3 too much, so. So I think that was fine. Olivia's Attendants. Okay, there's a mischievous guy, cat guys. But also, look at these red cards. So there's a very good red rare, and then there's the Rending Flame. Well, I'm not red, so I don't think I have to make a decision between those. But then the question is, what is the pick here? This thing can get an instant or sorcery, but I don't have too many of them. I have only three instants, no sorceries. I could take the Lantern Bearer. I mean, I know I could take the red card, a red card here, but I don't think I'm gonna move to red here now. Mischievous Catgeist. I don't know. I'll take the one drop here. It's the cheapest card anyway. Okay, so here I could take the Soulcypher board. I think I picked it in some early draft, but I ended up cutting it because I just thought that it's too slow, and maybe it is. I have options with them. Well, I have a lot of blue and black cards here, but I think it's gonna be between Diecraft Scavenger and the Geist here. But I like the Scavenger more, so let's take that one. And here, another bounce spell. Another Scattered Thoughts, another Undying Malice. So I have already one copy of each of this and this card, and the rest won't be for my colors. So if I'm gonna play two of some of these, which is the correct? I think I'll take the. I mean, I probably won't be playing any of these. Yeah, but I'll take the Undying Malice, I think. Don't really think about playing two of these retrievals. Although, if I don't have a lot of interaction removal, fine. Okay, let's take the bounce spell, but that will easily be cut. I mean, the other copy. I do like to play one, but maybe two is a bit too much. Anyway, the bounce spells, of course, are a loss of a card. So I get tempo, but I do lose a card. Here, I think the pick is the Thirst for Discovery. But I like the other options here too. But I think this is just a better card. So much cards and at a fairly cheap cost, and it's also an instant. So let's take that and see what the other options are here. Okay, there's a Mind Lich Ghoul. There's a Screaming Swarm. I'm not gonna take the throngs here. But I could take the two drop here over the Screaming Swarm. I have a six drop already. If I want to play a six drop, I'll take the Mind Lich Ghoul, whatever. And here, I took one knife. I don't think I want to take another one, but I could take the Blinding Geist. It's fine. Nothing wrong with that. I don't even have that many zombies, so this will sometimes cost the full 3 mana in this deck. All right, let's take the three drop here. And now. Another Mind Lich Ghoul. I don't have too many synergy pieces, but I guess I still need some 2-drops, or maybe I don't need, but I still want to have some 2-drops. I'm not gonna take the another Scattered Thoughts or the Phalanx, so let's just take the card I might be playing. And okay, well, that is actually interesting pack because I have a Ragged Recluse, but do I have way how many things? I think I might take the zombie thing here. I don't have a lot of zombies though. But I'll take it anyway. I mean, it will trigger out of. I mean, it will trigger of itself, is nothing else. Here it's gonna be. I don't like the Serpentine Ambush. I think it's quite bad. Don't think I'm gonna play this. There's an entire pack left with all of. I mean, yeah, I'll take this, but I think I'm not gonna play two of those, and I will have enough playables because I'm at 20 now, and there's still pack 3 left. So I have a Wandering Underlight Spirit, and I have a Binding Geist, and I don't think I wanna. Okay, I'll take the Geist, but it's likely that I won't be playing either of those. I might play the Innocent Traveler though. Let's see if that happens or not. well, I'm not gonna take this. Fine, whatever. Let's take the Scattered Thoughts. I don't know. Chill of the Grave might be a card I'm gonna play. Okay. Well, there is. There's an easy pick here. The Dread Feast Demon is just too good to ignore. I mean, it is a 7 drop, but it's such a bomb rare. I'm gonna take it here. The other options would be a third Diagraph Scavenger, Rottide Gargantua, or maybe the Evolving Bulge, but this is just too good. Let's take that one. And now I wouldn't maybe mind. Maybe I should play the Heirloom now, but let's see in the end. I mean, I don't have to make the. And that decision right now. Here there's a Gift of Fangs, which I think I'm gonna take. I lack some cheap interaction here. I wouldn't mind having another Diver's Cup or maybe another Arch Goal of Trapping, but cheap interactions might be what I need most here. And well, I don't like the Throngs at all, so I'm not gonna take it. The 5 drops. Yeah, I don't need this expensive stuff. I'm not gonna take the Skywarp Scarp here. I will take either the Doomed Dissenter or maybe the Evolving Wilds. But I have one Evolving Wilds already, do I not? I have a couple of mileage goals, so maybe I should take the Dissenter. Yeah, it's a really decent exploit. You know, synergy here. I want maybe take another mileage goal. I have enough 2 mana cards now. Or do I? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's fine. I'll take another Evolving Wilds. Makes my mana better. And here, Siphon Essence, Cradle. Tough choice actually. I don't think I have room for any of these, so I might just take an uncommon. Because this is 30 cards, but it's 28 non-lands, so I cut at least 5 cards here. Or maybe, well, let's say 4 or 5 cards, but that's still a lot of cards to cut. So maybe I'll just take a random uncommon. This is a best of one draft, so there's no sideboarding I need to care about. Maybe here it's gonna be a Galtanos Quest, and then here it's gonna be. Doesn't matter, I'm not gonna play any of these. And here there's a Groom's Finery, another Doomed Dissenter, and a Ragged Recluse, but I don't think I have that many ways to get those blood tokens, so maybe the Recluse is that bad. There is another Evolving Wilds there, but I have 2 of them, so maybe I'll just take the. I don't know, let's take the equipment here. I'm not sure what I want to have. Gargantua is not a good option. Whatever here. I don't think I'm gonna play 2 Chill of the Graves. I might play 1, but I also might easily cut it. This can also probably be put to the sideboard right away. Alright, well, there are a bunch of things. Well, I have. I'm not gonna take the Scattered Thoughts. Maybe the Blood Fountain, but maybe not. Let's take the Scarp and let's decide them on the exact cards to play a bit later, maybe. So, okay. One more card. Okay, so I have these blue cards in my sideboard. I have 2 of these retrievals on the deck already, one of the Chill of the Graves. I suppose I have let's see how many zombies, 8 here. Okay, fine. Let's put that there just in case, but I don't think I can fit both of them. I have so many cuts to make. I have a dreadlight monstrosity there. And two scattered thoughts there, yeah. Okay, so not gonna play third one for sure. And not gonna play two of these, so yep, let's see the actual deck now, but this will stay in the sideboard. So that's probably 10 cuts. Yeah, because with the Dread Feast Demon, I definitely play 17 lands. Now I could play also something like a Anod Heirloom to make sure I have easier time to get to 7 mana. Well, I suppose I could do that. Let's put that in the deck, but I don't think that's a required thing to do. Especially with the scattered thoughts, I will find with one of these. I'm most likely gonna cut one of these. I mean, so I will have one in the deck. But with the one, I can kind of assume it's sort of a land because if I want to, I can find lands with it. So maybe the Heirloom will be an easy cut here now. But let's see now. What are the easiest cuts? I think the both Undying Malice should. Oops, not the. What the heck? Not that. Take the knife back. The both of the Malices, Undying Malices should go. And then I think one of the bounce spells should go. Groom's Finery. How important would that be? The Blood Servitor, that should go. I don't need really that thing. And let's cut the Heirloom and let's cut one of the scattered thoughts. And now we are more like in the. Now this is the part where the cuts start to be a bit tougher. I think the monstrosity should go because I prefer my five drops, and I have the seven drop here, so these six drops are not that important, and I will need to still cut four cards. The Groom's Finery is probably not for this deck, so I'll cut that. And then the Arch Goal. So this cares about zombies. I don't know, eight zombies, maybe a three mana. This will most likely be just a three mana 3/2. I would need to have more of my creatures to be zombies. I have, well, for example, now I haven't finished with all the cuts, but now currently I have 8 zombies out of 19 creatures. So that's a fairly low amount of zombies altogether. So think I should cut this. And I think I also should cut at least one of the Chill of the Graves, maybe even both. I mean, I'm gonna cut this because this will be a 3 mana 3/2. It's not easy to hit more zombies with this thing, so let's cut it and then one of these, and then that leaves me one cut to be made. But I have, let's see, I have these exploit. How many exploit stuff I have some number of that. So, okay, yeah, these two drops and these five drops. But I have a couple of Doomed Dissenters. Did I cut something that's very good to be exploited? Well, the Arch Goal, maybe. But I don't think. No. I have here enough. I mean, I have these Dissenters and. And I guess the Binding Geist can work. I have two of these. Yeah, sacrificing these won't be the worst thing. And the Lantern Bearer, which I think I will be playing. Yeah, I'll be playing that. That's fine too. So maybe with eight, sorry, seven zombies now, I could maybe play one of the Chill of the Graves. But what would be the final cut? I like playing one of these Alchemist's Retrievals, and knife will be. It's actually quite decent. I would play in most decks one knife nowadays. Yeah, I'll play all the two drops here, just for curb reasons, if nothing else. I guess one of the binding geists could be cut, but I also want to be curbing out. Wait a minute, the Vandalite Spirit. Is that something this deck kind of doesn't care about? Because I'm not an aggressive deck that cares about just attacking a lot. Because, yeah, this is a 2-power flyer for 3 mana, which can't block ground creatures. And it's not very good at raising others either, because it is just 2 power. So, I mean, if opponent curbs out playing, like, a, let's say, 3 power, 3 drop, and I play this, especially if I'm on the draw, I can't block the 3 drop, and then I can, yeah, this is an evasive creature, but looking at the deck, I don't think I have that much trouble winning. I mean, if there's like a board style, I have that, of course, the Bomb Rare, some of these 5 drops here, some other flyers, the Death Toucher. I like the Binding Geist just more than I like the Vandalite Spirit, because this can at least block something and trade with the creatures that have up to 3 toughness. I'm gonna cut the Spirit here, the curve seems fine, everything seems fine here. I think this is the deck. So, and I have the Thirst and the Scattered Thoughts to find me more lands. Because of course you don't have to discard a land, and you can just also draw multiple lands with this thing. So the 7 drop isn't a problem. I can also use blood tokens to discard some non-lands to maybe find lands. I mean, in cases when I have the Dreadfeast Demon in my hand but don't have enough lands yet. So I have ways to get to 7 mana here. And this is of course just an automatic win. I mean, when I cast this and the opponent can't kill this before my end step begins, and assuming I have at least one other creature, and I don't think there's any other demons here. No, it's the only demon. So it's just an automatic win. This is a crazy Bomb Rare, but it is a 7 mana card, so you won't be able to cast this always. You might, you know, lose the game before, or even win. I mean, you can lose or win the game before you get the 7 mana. But yeah, anyway, point is that with just the 17 lands, you won't always get to 7 mana that often, but with the card draw I have here, it is definitely more, you know, easier to get there. All right, fine. That's enough talking about the deck. Let's just put the basics with a couple of evolving wilds. This mana base will be quite good. Probably more black mana because of the number of cards I have. Two blue double casters, but I have 2 black here as well. Yeah, it's easily gonna be more swamps and then islands. It will still be a very good mana base because of the 2 evolving wilds. So it's going to be 8 swamps and 7 islands, and that's 10-9 mana base. 10 and 9 should give me very good starting hands most of the time. So I quite like the deck. 17 creatures, 6 non-creatures, not a lot of removal actually, but at least I have some Death Touchers here, some rares here, and some interaction still. Okay, let's just go and see how the games go. No, why is it a 3 swamp hand? Man, my deck has, what's, 8 swamps, 2 evolving wilds, and 7 islands, and I still don't have. And I have a black card in my hand, but it's a 4-drop. Yeah, this has to be mulligan. I like the... I mean, this is an amazing curve. Well, not amazing necessarily, but if one of these was an island, imagine how good this hand is. I have to mulligan. I won't be gambling with the island draw. Let's keep this, of course, and then... I mean, I have a 2-mana 2-2, won't be able to use the exploit, not that I care about it much. I think my early stuff will be the Gift of Fangs. And then I can trade with something using the Binding Geist, and then the Scattered Thoughts will find me more cards, and I will use the keep these lands. So I will actually lose my 2-drop here, because I feel like the 2-mana 2-2 isn't that important now. And well, that's something I can kill right away, or I can wait for to see what's their 2-drop. It's most likely gonna be the so that I won't be having a 2-drop myself, so I should see what their 2-drop is, and I might want to use the Gift of Fangs on that instead. I don't care if they gain one life or attack for one. Well, they did not, but I did actually draw a 2-drop, so let's wait for more information. I'll play this rather than use the Gift of Fangs here, and then I most likely will be playing my Binding Geist as well here. Okay, they have nothing so far. Okay, well, don't think it matters too much. This is of course good with the exploit stuff I just drew, and it's not that such a bad idea to also sacrifice this for exploit, because it has some, you know, still utility when it's in their graveyard. But I kept three lands, have drawn three cards, none of them was land yet. I definitely want to have a land for this. Oh, that's well, okay, weird stuff going on here. First of all, they might... I mean, are they gonna exile this thing before I get to 5 mana? Because it's possible. But they also haven't done anything. They played 1-drop and then... on their turn 4, they played the Sigardian. Sigardia's Imprisonment. Okay, anyway, I have to get lands, so this is actually not a bad draw, because at least I get some blood tokens now, and this is a 2-1, which they are not gonna block. I mean, okay, they let me have a... Why would they do that? I mean... Well, I can't sacrifice it to exploit anymore. Maybe... I don't know what... I really am... What? Why would they do that? This was a good draw, a darn good draw, but... They have a lifelink here now. Should I just have the Scattered Thoughts here instead of equipping? Because I'm not feeling like... Yeah, I'll play the Scattered Thoughts now. They can have their 2 life. But yeah, I'm not really impressed about things they have played here in this game. I mean, I'm in a very good shape. No blocks there, and then I'm gonna get a land, most likely a land with this. But I don't know, who knows, I can take 2 spells too. That's fine. Definitely fine there. Alright, well, I'm going to keep this Dreadfist Demon because it's so good. I could take the... I don't take this Chill of the Grave. I could take the Scavenger, but... Okay, the problem with the Evolving Wilds is that it's a tapped land. Yeah, I'll take the Scavenger instead. Yeah, I would maybe take an untapped land over this thing, but... I might still draw a... might still draw a land here, of course. But if I take the Evolving Wilds, what's my next turn? Gift of Fangs doesn't do anything, I can equip this and that's it. This thing has menis. I'll take the Scavenger. But hopefully I will draw a land. did not, but the bounce isn't bad either. I can't, maybe they won't be, you know, exiling this, hopefully at least. But now, yeah, let's just play this, whatever. And yeah, I know I could have bounced this thing for one mana, but I just rather sacrifice it for one of my exploit things and hope that the opponent won't be. Okay, so they are gonna. I mean, they can trade with both of these, but that's probably fine. If they have interaction, they can kill the 2/3 and then eat the 2/2 for free. I don't know really. I mean, I will win the late game. Maybe if they have interaction, I just want to get rid of that stuff. Yeah, okay, I'll do this. I let the happen, this thing happen really. Because the 2/2 token came from the dissenter, which already traded with a card, so it's not even that bad. Are they really gonna, don't, oh man. That wasn't expected at all. I mean, I don't draw this. What the heck? Thought I'm gonna get value out of my. So the best play they had was to use 5 mana to exile my thing they already had pacified. Okay, well, whatever. I'm gonna play this and not sacrifice anything because I would have to sacrifice the 5/4 for them to sacrifice this, so decline this. Interesting. Well, I mean, still, the game plan is to win with this Dreadfist Demon, of course, so I'm not that worried about the. I mean, I'm at 20 and they only have 4 cards here. I have more plays to be making here. Okay, well, now. Annoying. That's really good for. Man. I don't know why did it happen this way, but. It did. Maybe I wasn't supposed to double block the the vampire there. Okay, well, thirst for discovery is good. So I could just play this, but it can't even block this. It can if I do this, but well, let's do this. I wanna see what I draw here. Okay, well, it's an easy discard of one land here because next, I mean, I will be at. 7 mana with 1 land draw, and I have a creature I can sacrifice for the Dreadfist Demon, and that's of course just a sick 7 drop. I will take 5 here, of course, but I mean, and yeah, well, I suppose I can also, if I don't draw, I can also just bounce it with the Alchemist Retrieval, but and I don't care about them getting life, that's not really important so at all. Alright, so now this is actually. Yeah, this is now interesting because they could have the 4 drop that exiles a creature. I mean, they could also have a Hero's Downfall, 3 mana. Instant that destroys a creature or planeswalker, because the Dreadfist Demon wins the game if I just can play it so that it will give me another Dreadfist Demon. But now it might just not happen. So I think. I think what I'm doing here is that I want to make sure that I can. Okay, but yeah, I'm actually doing it like this. So I want to play this when they have less mana up than this. Do they kill it? Yeah, they had the Hero's Downfall, so that is Good. So I think I'll just. I was intending to bounce this and make them replay it. But now that I do need to have a creature on the battlefield when I play these to make it, you know, valuable. So I think it's gonna be worth returning target non-land permanent you control. So let's do this and recast it. And I can take another 5 damage here still. And then I hope. I could give this +2/+2 because it's a vampire. And then I could block this, but I guess I can go to. It's also risky if they have removal. So basically, I just want them to. I mean, do they actually have just a removal in their hand and they're not gonna tap their mana for anything? Because they're not using the blood token either, which is really kind of concerning here. Okay, they get more cards, but they have the 4 mana up. Am I? This is really awkward if they just pass here now. Come on, play just any creature, please. Oh, because they can have the. Okay, good. And that's also something I can kill with the Gift of Fangs very nicely. So if I draw a land, that would be fantastic. I'm not going to discard the Diver's Garb though, to in order to find a land. I don't think that's necessary. But and I draw it. So this is now. This should be most likely a victory now. Attack for 1, and then do this, play this, and I'll have 2 of these demons. I mean, they could have 2 removal spells. If they do, I won't be. Ah, Toxrill. Well, well, well. That's really good. Wow. The scavenger though helps a bit, but I can't deal with. I mean, I can bounce it. This says creatures you don't control get. Okay, they have slime. My creatures have slime counters, not -1/-1 counters. So I think at some point I will use this Diver's Cup, but not now. I don't think. I will attack for 10 now. Play the scavenger, and it will become a Dreadfast demon. Which will be a 6/6. I mean, it won't be able to. I mean, actually, the death art is slightly more, but I can make it into. I mean, if they have removal, I will just lose then. I will lose. So, do I have to actually get rid of the tuck? Well, I'm going to equip here and. Attack for 11, yes, that's right. And I might just bounce this to on top of that. Just don't feel like I'm using the Diver's Cup right now. But it is risky. Yeah, because they have exactly 12 power here. And if I drain something here, that will mean that I mean, I guess I could leave the Dreadfist demon here to block the Rottide Gargantua. But I need to win the game also, because this thing will just they will also get a slug token, but it actually doesn't matter too much because my guys fly. And they don't have blue mana to draw a card from the slugs either. So now the question is, am I going to just bounce this, which means that I will sacrifice, of course, one of these guys. They will recast it. But I won't have a victory on the next turn, will I? No, it's just, but I guess I have to do like this. Because if they have removal on this thing, if I play the scavenger, they will remove it and then they will win. I will go to 12, but this is 12 damage they can deal if they remove my only blocker. So. And they have this lifelinker. They discard a blood fountain, okay. So let's see how it goes. They don't have an attack if they play the 7 drop unless they have some cheap card they can also use to make the attack profitable. But they're also not gonna lose now. I guess it is rare against rare now. Do they have two? Yeah, well, they didn't. They played the 7 drop there. Makes sense. And no attack. This gets another counter. This will die, so I can. I have four. Okay, I can play both of these. They both will be actually become. Yeah, okay. This is the sick part, of course, of the card. All my creatures become, because with two of these on the battlefield, these both will become 6/6 flyers now. So is there any reason to attack with only one? Because of course I don't want to lose to a double removal spell, which they could have, but. Because if I attack them down to 7 now, I'm very likely going to win on the next turn. If I attack them down to 12 by leaving one of these. I mean, I guess I'm going to actually just. Leave this blocker here. Because I think I will win on the next turn anyway. I only need to deal 10 damage with the creatures I have. They can, but they can gain 5. I kind of forgot that. That is true. Yeah, they can gain 5 here now. Maybe I was supposed to attack with both. Well, let's see how it goes. They do get a bunch of slug tokens. Wait a minute, what happened? What did I miss here? I missed some interaction here now. Why did I lose my other? Wait a minute, what happened there? Why did I lose? Why don't I have two more 6/6 now? Okay, they have an armed task. Well, they will get 8 more life. So let's see what. I don't understand why I. My land. Okay, they have a bright scout which they can use to. Do I lose now? Maybe, but what the heck just happened? Why don't I have two of these 6/6 now? At the beginning of each end step. It's not just on the end step. So the lantern bearer actually, I was supposed to use the blood token to get rid of it. That I thought they only get slime counters on their own end step. Okay then. Well, I mean, that's it. That's how it goes then. So that was just a mistake. I have to block, of course, here, yeah, both of these, and I can't even kill either both. Yeah, I mean. No, this is 11 damage. I only need to block one of them. But they get 10 life, so I'm gonna be in a bad shape here. I mean, they deal 10 here. No, this is wrong. Like that. That's 11 damage. I didn't realize the blood token happens on each end step. Man. Okay, yeah. Let's lose. The lifelink here matters so much here. I mean, I'm gonna lose with Dreadfist Demon, but of course, only because they have this. Yeah, so the Lantern Bearer. Yeah, this died before it was able to become a 6-6, because their triggers, of course, resolve first on my turn and they. On each end step, man. So let's see if I find some other answer. This is not. The Innocent Traveler is not the answer, so let's discard to draw. Discard to draw, I think it's not gonna work here, because they have. I mean, they already. Even if I get to. Yeah, I'm not gonna win here. Yeah, it's just not gonna happen here. Because they have. I have one life and they have so many attackers here. Yeah, that was weird. And I'm also super frustrating that I got to 7 lands while I was what? At 20 life, and I still lost with my bomb rare, because they had a better bomb rare for that situation at least. But oh well, it was a battle of bomb rares, and there's one. It's fine. Okay, let's see if this time I can win with this thing. Well, first of all, I first need to get to 7 mana, but hopefully that happens. Okay, land isn't bad. Now I can play. Maybe I miss my 3 drop, but it's not like I have a. I mean, any kind of rush here. Can they have a. Do they have a exploit stuff there? I don't think they have exploit right now because of the attack there. Okay. Well, no attacks. I will block the red strong maybe. Yeah, I will pay. At least I get to. Maybe they will get a stupid trigger though. Yeah, this is too good to exploit actually. Yeah, okay, fine. No blocks, and I will play this 2-3 just even though I can't. Even though I can't drain 2 here, and that's. Well, I guess I can drain, and it's very decent that I get rid of the thing that can come back. I'm happy they didn't sacrifice the red strong, and also a bit surprised they didn't sack it. Okay, well, anyway, let's do this before they can. Use this, and I will just block with the Diecraft Scavenger here. The Scattered Thoughts wasn't bad at all, because it allows me to find more lands for the Red Fist Demon, which will win the game. Hopefully this time it didn't win in the game one, match one, whatever. It's the same thing, match and game is the same thing in best of one. In best of three, the match is the thing, you know, that. The match is up to 3 games. Well, it could be more if they are drawn games, but you know, that's the terminology. I really just want to draw a land here, because I have 5-drop, 5-drop, 7-drop here, but if I don't draw a land, I can at least play the Scattered Thoughts if I don't wanna play the card I draw. I guess something like an Evolving Wilds would be a fine draw too. I have 2 of those in my deck. Gargantua won't be that good right now, because they will sacrifice the Lantern Bearer. Oh, I have this thing in my deck too. Well, not that I... Not that I'm going to play it now. Whenever this or another non-token creature you control dies, get a blood token. And at 5 blood tokens, it will become better, but... I mean, there's some merit in actually playing it. But let's just do this and find something. So yeah, absolutely, a land is gonna be happening here. The Gluttonous quest is... The Mindlit's goal. No, I will use them. I mean, I could just take the two lands. It's really not a bad idea at all. Next turn I play the 5 mana card, which is gonna be most likely the Gargantua, and then I have... Okay, I'll take actually the lands here. I think that makes, in the end, the most sense. Okay, no attacks. And now I do have two creatures in my graveyard. Actually three, so I can use the Skywarp Scarp now to draw an extra card to make my Dread Feast Demon happen. And there's no point even playing the Gargantua, because it, I mean, they can sacrifice either the Red Strong or the Lantern Bearer, neither of which is very good for me. So I'd rather just have this Doom Dissenter to, you know, be sacrificed for the Dread Feast Demon, because it can... Oh, what's this then? They have... They don't play anything here. They have 6 mana up with 4 cards in hand, and they don't play anything on their turn, so that's kind of feeling like a counter spell. So I maybe should play the Gargantua, because that's the thing I want to get countered. I don't wanna... This thing will draw me a card. Yeah, okay, if they... Yeah, I'm gonna actually do this. And I'm not gonna use the exploit. If it resolves, it is. I don't expect it to resolve. But if it resolves, I'm not gonna use the exploit, because them sacrificing one of these things... If they didn't have the throng there... But yeah, let's yeah, they have that. So I got... Sadly, it was this bomb. Well, not... Well, I mean, this rare counter spell. Not great, but I'm still able to win with the Dread Feast Demon, but... of course, now the clock is sadly a lot faster. So let's see how it goes. I mean, Dread Feast Demon is still gonna win the game rather easily if it resolves. I mean, and if it resolves and I get to go to my end step, that's the thing. I will take only 4. Of course, I'm at 17, so I'm not dying now or not on the next turn or the turn after that. But well, I didn't draw land, so not... I don't have the Dread Feast Demon here. But man, that's annoying. Okay, let's do this now. Then I'll play the Bloodcaster or whatever. But the opponent didn't... I mean, I know they have the 2-1 here. So they have only instant... They didn't even play a land here. So this means they have 5 cards in their hand that are... I mean, they all, of course, have 5 cards in their hand. But none of them is a land, most likely. And I drew 3... None of them was a land. I have to discard 2 in here, which is gonna be the Ceremonial Knife and... Nothing... No cheap card will be... Maybe the Diver's Cup is just the... Okay, these two will go away. And because I'm... fairly certain they will have a counterspell. Maybe I will do the Jacob here, because if they counter it, at least they use it on that, not on the Dread Feast Demon. And if they don't counter or kill it, I will have a better chance to have a 7th land on the next turn. But this is really... Okay, yeah, that was a syncopate. Are they gonna have a third counter spell? Because that would be really awkward. Well, first of all, I need to draw the seventh land, but the Skywarp Scarp, of course, helps me get there. Also blocks these things here, so... is this gonna be another game where I have a Dreadfish Demon, which isn't gonna help me win? It's really weird stuff. I mean, this is an unfair rare, so maybe it's kind of like a I deserve it sort of thing, but also if the opponent just has all these and then all counter spells. Not too happy about that either. Just play the red strong. Oh, they have another counter spell. Well, I guess I'll just play the Wandering Bloodcaster and see them counter this. Oh, if it's a syncopate, they can't counter that. Man. But they can... how do I do it? I should have played the Skywarp Scarp first, because they could not counter it with a syncopate. Well, if they have a syncopate, I need to do this. Yeah, fine. Okay, whatever. Counter it. And then... How awkward can it be? I have this thing and I can't even cast it. Yeah. What a game. What a game. I'm gonna take 6 in the air now. Well, I guess I can block the Lantern Bear, but I don't really want to lose the Bloodcaster because it will become a 6-6, but... Cannot take here this much damage. Can you imagine this? They had to syncopate. And after having the amalgam. Now this was the first time I could have played the Dreadfish Demon, but I still could have resolved some useful stuff there. If they didn't have all this, so this is just a joke because they happen to have the perfect draw here. Well, anyway, I'll just because if I go to 3, it's gonna be so tough now. I have lost the game already, but I guess I just have to jump most damage here and hope that at 6 life I can still win with the Dreadfish Demon, because of course the Doom Descender will be good. But if they have any more interaction, I have lost the game. Whatever, and they have more flyer. And if they still don't play the red strong, it's gonna be just a... Okay, they finally did. But now, is that gonna be enough? Because I'm at 6 now. So, this will get me a 2-2 ground blocker for the throng. I will have 2 flyers, I'll get the 3 and... Did they forget to use the foreboding statue, by the way? It should be 5-5 by now, but they did forget it, okay? But 3 blockers will block... Maybe it's enough. I don't know. I mean, assuming they have nothing, but they do have 2 spells. So yeah, I mean, just bounce, whatever. Bounce spell, kill spell, anything will be enough for them to win, because I need exactly 3 blockers here. If I have only 2 blockers, I will lose. Yeah, okay. That's how it goes. Well, I guess the Dreadfish Demon doesn't win after all when the opponent has this stuff there. Okay. Yeah. Well, no, that's not a... I can still block with that thing. Okay, I'm alive. Barely. But I can play 2... They should have played it in the other order because they could have... Gotten the trigger for the fear of death, but I suppose, and these flyers, and so the opponent, and conveniently they did mill 2 lands there. Okay, anyway, I will block this, go to 3 here. But I will get two demons now. Now, if I sacrifice the Dreadfist demon here, I will get only one more demon. That's not going to happen. I mean, I'm not going to do that. So, yeah, I'm still going to have a chance to win here. So let's do this stuff. No attacks. I need this to be a blocker. Five lands, all spells, and these were milled by the fear of death. Oh man, you are kidding me. Ah, this is insane. I'm losing this fight, I mean, by a mile. They have their own Dreadfist demon. Okay, I'm not gonna win this fight. They are soon have a board full of 6/6 flyers, and I'm at 3 life, they are at 16, and they have way more creatures than I. Oh, 2 start. What the heck? How hard can it be to win some games? If I'm gonna go 0-3 here, I'm not even sure if I can have my sanity. Well, this is a great hand though, but I mean, I'm still probably gonna get the top 1200 finish, but man, is it annoying too. I mean, this is, if you have followed my drafts, my previous drafts, I had a bunch of good ones. Well, I had the 6 winner previous time, but this starts to be pretty annoying now. If this is gonna be the trend, I need to get more, you know, drafts with more wins than losses. If I even want to go to mythic rare and but of course I mean mythic rank. I also need to be in top 1200. So it's not gonna be. That's not the end. All right. So let's just focus on this game though. There's the Jacob. This only count zombies. Count zombies, so I should attack with the goal here and then just play the scattered thoughts. That's what I will do here. Okay, they do the trade here though. This will be, that's kind of, they killed my goal and got a 2/2 token out of it, but that's the best thing you can expect from the Headless Rider with this card draw here. I don't care about getting 2-for-1. Okay, this stuff is good. I think I should just take the non-lands here now. That's completely fine because I can play both of my 2-drops now and get the 5th land with the Evolving Wilds. Which should be which one is it? Don't think it matters. I have a double boat, so let's just take the blue for instance. Pack song pop. Okay, well that can keep growing. Annoying. Don't have 2 creatures here, so a scarp won't be doing much. I can I can use a Jacob Hogan here. I think the bug might still be. Yeah, I mean, if I block and use this, it might crash the game. Because they were supposed to fix that bug, but I'm not sure if that patch has been applied yet. Because they tried to apply the patch, but then they had to re... it was so buggy that they had to go back to the previous version. Alright, anyway, what is the... What other plays? I can sacrifice... I can get the... Yeah, so how it works? Exile card, you may... Oh, yeah, of course, this, that's how it works. I can use this and then cast one of these cards for free. So the Gargantua, most likely. Okay, let's do it. Draw a card. Exile this. Auto pay this. And then I can play this for free. Yeah, that's how it works. And I will sacrifice, I guess. I mean, do I even want to trade this on with something like I have here? Probably not. I will get a blood token though. But it's gonna be the Snarling Wolf. Too bad they have the Spoback Wolf, because otherwise making them lose the Snarling Wolf would be fine because of the Pack Sunk Pop. Yeah, fine, decline this. I'm not gonna block with this, so I'll attack with it. Okay, that is good for the Spoback Wolf, but I think I still wanna deal with the scavenger here. Because it has death touch. Okay, that's a free. Sadly that's not what I need here. I need something else. I guess I'll play this and try to fight my Dreadfist demon, I suppose. Let's do this. The retrieval will be useful. Also, this diver scarp will be useful. This costs 2 mana when I try to bounce their stuff, so maybe... Man, the opponent is at 4 lands and all spells. This is... It's not the kind of game I really wanted to have here. Because I'm definitely just, you know... having trouble here. So I can play the goal and them exiling a card isn't maybe even relevant. So maybe I'll just play this and then have the alchemist retrieval, which I need to have there. The goal won't be able to trade with anything here. Well, it can trade with a 2/2, but this can be cast from this from the graveyard. I might use the goal still, although I wanna... Okay, let's do this. I've been losing. Okay, I'm gonna do this because I actually want to... Well, I don't know. It was optimal use of mana or something like that. But I'm in trouble now. I'm definitely in trouble now. Block here. I'm gonna bounce the Lumbernaut, right? This will deal 2, this will deal 4. I'm not dying yet, but I'm just wondering if I should double block the Snarling Wolf. No, it's bad kind of because... I will lose my Bloodcaster, but maybe I just have to lose it. Probably I just have to do it. I'll take 6 damage anyway. I'm in trouble. I'm in huge amount of trouble here. I mean, I have to do something because I'm running out of time. Man. I don't know. I might even lose if they have a +3/+3 effect. Maybe this wasn't supposed to happen. They don't even have to use 2 mana on this to trade with the Bloodcaster here. I lose the +3/+3 trick here. At least they didn't have that. And I get some life from these blood tokens because of the Gluttonous quest. But I'm not sure I like my chances too much here. Let's get something other than a land. Okay, that is really good. That is really good. Let's cast that right away for free and get the 2 life here and the Death Toucher. This is... Yeah, that was important. And then I can use the Diver's Cup to eat the Lantern Bearer to get the Paxong Pup reset. Probably worth it. That I maybe should have used the blood token already, but I also have run the risk of decking out, so I need to find. Well, I suppose I will find the Dread Feast Demon, unless it's like the last card in the deck. But I need to find a way to win here too. But now I'm at least somewhat stabilized, and I will get to use the Lantern Spirit on the Diver's Cup, of course, and I will still discard this thing. Okay, that's fine. They don't have an attack now. I mean, they could attack, but don't think it's that good for them. Okay, that's fine. I mean, because this is really not that great. Why would they? Well, let's use this first. I mean, it's fine, I guess, they get to trade, but I don't mind trades here. Trades are good. So, this kills this and this. I guess they might, yeah, well, they get rid of the Gluttonous quest, so it won't gain any more life. But I'm actually not that interested in drawing more cards, because I might get decked in here. And the Spoback Wolf trading with the Gluttonous quest isn't so bad. So let's just do this here, and they have a plus... It wasn't the +2/+2, I was worried, but they had only a swamp there. So they actually were able to do that. I have a Geist here. I'll play that for free. I have this thing. Yeah, I need my Dread Feast Demon, I really do. Well. Okay, I'll draw the card. That's not necessary either. So let's see, if I do attack and they block, I use the Gift of Fangs to kill this, then I can't use the Chill of the Grave. But I need to win also. That's the thing here. So if they take 3, I'll get 2. But this will deal... No, I can't do that. But this will be a 4-4. I mean, it will be dealing 4, not being a 4-4. Gluttonous quest. Okay. So they are not running out of the... They're not running out of... I mean, I hope they have a land drop, because... Do they still have 2 spells? Well, anyway, I'll do this. Come on, Dread Feast Demon, don't be the last card in the deck. Okay. Descender, oh man. 8 cards left. Eight cards left. Gift of Fangs doesn't. I have no vampires here. Well, let's do this. Start doing some damage. I guess I could have discarded an island, but I'm not really fond of losing more cards now. I mean, drawing more cards. Yeah, I need my Dreadfist Demon. Very soon. Very, very soon. So if I attack with these, I will have another blocker. I mean, I guess I have to just gamble a bit. Six now, because I need to find a way to maybe win without the Dreadfist Demon here. I could give you -2/-2, of course. That might be worth it. Might be worth it, in fact. Darn. It's a very good blocker, but I'm not sure if I... Okay, fine. I will attack only for four now. I want to have these blockers around. I'm at six. It's not a lot of life at all. This and don't need the knife here. But although the knife does give me +1 power, also I don't have to sacrifice my blood tokens. Okay, now they had to land, but they discarded. So I can keep -2. Why is this -1? Oh yeah, because I used this. No, that's right. Gift of Fangs, I don't need to use it now because I have all these blockers. I'll play this and end turn. Keep the island in hand just in case I actually want to use a blood token. But next turn I will need to use the Skywarp Scarab. Okay, there's that. Oh man. The heck, the Dreadfist Demon is in the bottom six. So... if I attack with the Diver's Cup though... But they just passed without the play. They might have, they haven't planes. Do they have a do they have well, they will have three block attackers next turn. And I don't have a lethal attack even if I no, I will just have to do, I have to do this right. I will leave these things to block. This will be a win on the next turn. And they have a fierce retribution. Okay, whatever. But they have only one card left, so I think I'm still winning. I have just about enough time here. -2/-0 doesn't do anything now that they have. Guess I'm still using it, but it doesn't really do a lot. I'll just play this, whatever. No, this is a vampire if it flips, I guess, so. End turn. Oh man, this is so hard. If I just had a Dreadfist Demon here. Holy Moon, does that give Trample? No, good. Because that would have been a horrible thing. I need to jump block that now. I can't. No, it is. No, no, sorry, sorry. It's day now. So I can. Unless they have a Trample thing, but if they do. It will be a 9-9 Trample in that case. So, sorry, a 9. Yeah, well, they can deal 9 damage with it. Trample damage. So, if I triple block it, they will get all of these killed. But then it will die though. And then I won't be dying to the trick either. Fine, let's maybe do this. This will play around the plus two and trample. Not sure if it makes sense. But this will trade these guys. The guys don't... I'm not sure. They will get to kill all of this stuff. I will get a 2-2 token, of course. But they are fine. If they have one last trick... They don't. Okay. But it will die at least. I have the insight here, so... I'm getting two cards per turn anyway. Alright, not gonna use these because I might get decked here. That's really the thing. Now, will they transform? Okay, they actually sack to... Okay, that's... Yeah, doomed. So the Dreadfist Demon is in my bottom four. Let's see if they have something for the Gift of Fangs here. Okay, that's dead. Do this. I forgot that thing. Totally forgot it. But I guess I can keep it -2/-2, so it's not bad, that big of a deal. And do I need to move this around? Probably don't care enough. But I'm gonna be dead in a couple of turns. I mean, I need to... And they get that, of course. But I have a blocker. I have the 1-3 on it. They can sacrifice them. Am I gonna get... Well, I have one more turn. Okay, Dreadfist Demon is on my bottom, in my bottom two cards. But I will win on the next turn, so this is really... I mean, I will go to zero cards. I can't even use these blood tokens, but I will win, don't I? They need to deal with the scum. They will need to deal anything with all the stuff here. Yeah, this should be victory now. Okay, it's victory because of these two. Let's do it right away. Alright. But I was gonna win it anyway. Man, that was... I mean, weird game. But at least I won. Let's win six more games now, shall we? Okay, decent enough. Get the swamp with this thing. I guess I could have played the Evolving Wilds in case I wanted to have the Binding Geist on turn 3, but it's fine still. But I do like the Lantern better now more than the 2-drop here. And this gets me, of course, a swamp because I have the Innocent Traveler here. Double caster here. Now I have a pretty good game here. Oh, well, not now, but they have... No, but what did I say? It's not a good game. It definitely is not. Because they get 3 card draws each turn, potentially. Can't even attack with my 1/1 flyer now, because they have a flying blocker. Okay, they have a turn 3 rare. I need my Dreadfist Demon now. I need my Dread Feast Demon. How many cards they're gonna draw with the Welcoming Vampire? Well, that's one. That is one. Well, I'll get a... And they two. Okay, now I need some removal on that thing. What the heck? They just play Gift of Fangs there. Can I even punish them for that? I mean, look at this stuff. I mean, who plays against a blue-black opponent at this stage in the game? I mean, I could have a bounce spell. I could have the 4 mana minus 13, minus 13. And a number of other things. And if I would be able to just use one card to deal with this and this, that would be so good for me. And no, I don't have the way to punish. This is, I mean... Wow, I just can't... Well, it's just one of those games then. I really liked my all the stuff I had here, but then they... I guess if they don't have a 2 power creature or 1 power creature, but of course they do, so yeah, that's already a second card they drew with that thing. But there's the Dread Feast Demon, so now that is gonna be useful. This is the beginning of combat, so they should have played this first, but anyway, it doesn't matter now. I need to just get to 7 mana, and then that will allow me to win. For that reason, I will be playing the Till of the Grave here. So let's. I mean, I might still lose to this catapult fodder. That's completely potentially a thing that can happen. But now the question is, I'm at 5 lands. If I draw a land with this thing, and the next draw will also be a land, then I should be doing this now so that I can hit my land drops. But it's also more value if I get to lock this down for a couple of turns. And I guess if the next two draws are gonna be lands, that's gonna be good enough for me. That's going to be good enough. So I'm gonna do it like this. That will I think I'll just block the catapult captain here. And that was no land. Although this can find me more lands. I just need to get the Dread Feast Demon, of course. ASAP. But I'm basically losing 10 life currently. Hero of Hope. They are never running out of cards. And there's no lands. I need to do this. I need to find a freaking land here. What the heck? And I'm not gonna discard a land here. I can't just do that. So I'm gonna discard him. Geist and... I think another Geist? And then I can either use a Geist on the Hero of Hope, because it will be a 3 power attacker, or I can use the Mind Lich goal, eat a Doomed Dissenter, make them exile one of the cards. But the Doomed Dissenter will be quite good with the Dread Feast Demons. They have a tapper, let's see if they're gonna tap something first. They are. No attacks. Man, I need to land next turn so bad. Do I have two creatures here? But yes, I do, but these are the binding guides, so I think... But no, on the other hand, I don't want to take any damage here. I might still take one, but... although I can jump block it too. This is tough. This is actually tough now. So... But I can lose to the catapult captain, even with the dreadfish demon. But yeah, okay, let's do this. Let's do this. If I don't draw a land next turn, I might just... It depends on if they leave 3 mana up for this thing. Okay. Okay, this is just a... They can use this only once per turn, of course. So I hope they do not leave 3 mana up for the catapult captain. And then I just need... I mean, I guess they can't use the Nebelcast. Well, no, now they can. Okay, this is just perfect for them. And I didn't draw a land. And that's after playing this thirst for discovery on the previous turn. Now, I did bin two lands with the Scattered Thoughts, but at that point, I didn't have the Red Feast Demon in my hand. Okay, so let's try to... attack first, but they can just win with the catapult captain, so no attacks. And then I need to draw a card, but no, I don't, I can't draw a card because I have only one creature here. So, can I find a kill spell on this? Do I have a kill spell on this? Because this is the thing that's gonna win me, although, also they can. I need to do this, even though I can't, even though I cannot, well, I can't, I mean, I need a blocker for this. I can jump block, but they can also tap it. I need a blocker. Ah, this is so insane. Why didn't I just draw a land? Why didn't I draw a land for the demon here? My deck has 1, 2, 3, 4, there's 7 lands left in there, okay. Come on, deck. Just give me the darn land. At least both Evolving Worlds are gone, so it's, if I draw a land, it's gonna be an untap one. But I'm still losing to this catapult cap. I'm not sure if I'm gonna win with the Dreadfist Demons. It's possible I won't be winning. I don't even care to do the math here. Okay, they get to return something now. Man, they had to turn 3 welcoming vampire, and all of the creatures they have played, literally everything, all of them have drawn their no card. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I mean, their hand of 5 cards is all because of this welcoming vampire. Otherwise, they would have run out. Now, I did draw my Dreadfist Demon, so that is good. And they don't actually have mana for the... They don't have mana for the catapult captain now, so that is also good. But let's see if they're gonna tap one of my flyers, and then do I have the opportunity to? No, they can attack. They can tap one of the Dreadfist Demons. I think I need a flying blocker here, though. That 2 damage might not be. Let's see. This has to be blocked because I can't take any more damage because of the catapult captain, so I think this needs to be a blocker. But now I should be in a quite good shape because I can start sacrificing these doomed dissenters here. This will gain me like a bit of life. Five. Yeah, I need to use this like 3 times before I lose. So I think I might have enough time because of course my entire board will become in 6/6 in a couple of turns. But if they do have 2 removal spells, okay, that's 1, but that buys them some time. Okay, yeah, but that's not enough for them to. That's not enough for them to, you know. I mean, it will still happen, even if they exile it. But yeah, this is. Okay, now this is interesting. Are they gonna? No, I have no. I don't have 6 power here. All right. Well, it's not that interesting after all. So. Okay then. How to do it? So I can't kill this, because if I could triple block it to kill this, I would then win, of course. I mean, not necessarily, but would be very likely to win. Killing the Tapper isn't really gonna do much. I think I have to jump block the Welcoming Vampire, do I not? It's funny how they just use this as a +2/+2 and I never drew anything that. I don't think my deck even has that much, but the fact they took the gamble and got it paid them off. I mean, this having more power, two more power is really nasty here, but oh well. Yeah, I wish. So, I mean, I can't take so much damage because this catapult captain is the problem here. So I can jump like every one of them. That's also one option. But then the problem with jumping is that I need the stuff for them. I think I'll need to do this at least. And also this. But I need these creatures to. I think I'll do it like this. I don't have all the information I need. I can make one of my guys to fly if I care about that. But the Diecraft Scavenger gets. I can use the Binding Geist. But, I think I'm gonna jump this anyway. I'm losing to this Catapult Captain. I fear I'm losing to the Catapult Captain indeed. They have more than. I mean, I guess I'll need to use them. Yeah, I'll just do this, get some life there and. Play the Lantern Bearer on the 2/2 here. Just to have a temporary flyer here. I need more flying blockers here. This I might use for the Gluttonous Quest. So. Let's do this. Can't attack now because I need some blockers. Yeah, draw all the cards. If they didn't have the Welcoming Vampire. If they just didn't have it. But now, they're gonna use the 2 catapult for the. Okay, I guess I can bounce now one of them. So that's giving me some kind of a chance here. But they also have jump blockers. Okay, well. They can draw. With the Gluttonous Quests, they can have 2 life per blood token. This is just insane. That's just how it goes. I'm gonna attack with this because if they do double block, I can use my. Although the retrieval, it won't that. Okay, they just. Okay, maybe I need to. If they choose to do that. This is fine, actually. I'm still losing, but I guess it's still fine. Okay. So they're counting on using both of these things. I mean, they have 2 catapult fighters. This is beyond laughable. All right, I need to use the bounce before they untap. So. I have 7 mana here. So So I guess I'll use okay, let's do this. And then I can play I think I was supposed to attack with the Diecraft Scavenger, not that it would have done. But yeah, they wouldn't have actually double blocked it, and they didn't have a good play. Yeah, maybe yeah, I should have actually attacked with this. That was a mistake. I thought only the Flyers matter here now. Well, anyway. I'm losing to the Catapult Captains. It doesn't matter. I just lose. Why do I waste any more time? This is fine. This is fine. I don't have a victory here. It's obvious that I won't be winning on the next turn. Because I don't have enough going on here. And I don't this blood token will gain me one life, but it does not matter. I will lose to their stuff anyway, so oh, I can sacrifice the 1/4 there. But I think I was supposed to attack with yeah. Okay. If I did attack with more guys there. Yeah, because they have the big color, they can tap some of my stuff. I need to. Can I draw something? Catapult fodder. That's gonna win them the game. But they never run out of cards just because they had to turn 3 Welcoming Vampire. They have drawn almost 10 cards here. They have even a flyer. Although they don't want to cast. I mean, no, they can activate it and. No, they don't have. They need to leave 3 mana up here. But they don't want to. No, they will win on the next turn because of the. Double catapult fodder here. Yeah, they just got the jump blockers here too. This is it's a fun event because I had Dreadfist Demon on the battlefield for so many times that still didn't give me the victory. I mean, I'm losing to these. They just sacrificed these 1/4s. It's funny that they got this 1/1 jump blockers too. I mean, they basically had it all. I can attack for. They have 3 blockers. They can block 3 of my 4 flyers. And they go to. What, 14 there? And then I lose the catapult captains here. That was. Yet another miserable draft. And my deck was really good and I drew my Bumbler in so many games. It just wasn't gonna be enough. But that was all because of the Welcoming Vampire. They even had what 4 cards still left in their hand. So of course I'm not gonna concede to a turn 3 Welcoming Vampire, but that really puts you on the back foot because opponent just never runs out of gas. They drew a card from each of their creatures almost until they lost the vampire, which was very late in the game. This deck was even without the Bumbler, I liked the deck quite a bit, but I had also the Bloodcaster and Jacob here. But of course the deck was with the Scattered Thoughts and the thirst for discovery. It was kind of designed to find the demon. But of course this can be in the bottom 5 cards. It was in the bottom 2 cards in one of the games. Funnily, that was one of the only game I won was the one where I had this in my bottom 2 cards. In all the 3 other games, which I lost, I had this available, but it didn't help. That was kind of funny, but I would say very unorthodox games in the sense that normally against like a In normal circumstances, I would have won those games with the Dreadfish Demon. But first of all, the one of the opponent had their own Dreadfish Demon, and well, the last game was just I lost to Catapult Fodderers after they drew a lot of cards from the Welcoming Vampire, and then the one other loss, I don't remember what it was, but also I thought I was in a good shape there, but I was not. Yeah, nothing else to say about the deck. It's just gonna be a huge grind to get to even the mythic rank here, apparently. I had I mean I'm again at yeah I started this event with three no two steps here. I lost both of them. I'm at tier one still, but it's been a quite a grind at tier one. I think this was my draft number 5 or 4 since I hit tier one for the first time, and I'm still here at tier one at zero progress steps. So this will continue. So the next one will be a premier draft. I won't be playing even any traditional drafts until I have, until either the month ends or I hit Mythic top 1200 with enough rank to not play anymore. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.